What's up, you guys? Stoops back again with another Lineage 2 Revolution sponsored video. And in these series of videos, I've been going over various features across the game, offering various tips to help you guys on your journey. But in today's video, we're going to discuss the concept of leveling. What's the best way to level? How do you level in this game? How do you catch up to your friends that are already way ahead of you? Well, hopefully that's not the case. But if that is the case, I'm going to go over some tips and tricks and just give you guys the rundown on how you level in this game, how you progress your character. Now, when starting out the game, the best way to level is simply to follow the main storyline, and is highlighted here on the left side of your screen. You will see an orange quest indicator, and you will simply click that and it will begin the main storyline quest. And as I've talked about in previous videos, there is a simple auto quest feature that you can turn on, and it will progress your character for you, so you can spend your time elsewhere looking through the various features across the game or trying to group up with your friends, as you do earn bonus experience when grouped up with other players in a party. Now, as this is a mobile game, you might have your auto quest feature enabled while you're on the go. So while you are questing, you can track your main storyline progress by clicking on the scroll at the top portion of the screen, and you can go through the different zones and see what areas you have completed, what is left for you to complete. So the game actually does an excellent job of organizing all of the quest lines and keeping you on track with this simple feature. But perhaps you reach a zone where the quests are too difficult, the mobs are too hard to kill, and you need to gain some bonus experience and levels before completing that specific quest. In these instances, there are daily quests that you can complete under the challenges tab. You'll then click your quests, and on the left side you have main quests, daily quests, and weekly quests. Now, each day you can complete 12 of these daily quests. However, you can only choose up to 3 active quests at once. Now, similar to your gear, these quests also have a grade system. The higher the grade, the better the rewards. And again, you can do 12 a day, but you can only have 3 going at once. Now, when it does come to your daily quests, you can opt to refresh these quests 3 times per day. Depending on the grade of the quest, you will receive better rewards, and if you complete all of your daily quests, you will then be rewarded with bonus addenda and bonus loot crates. So this is a simple feature to boost your overall experience gain while leveling doing the main storyline quest. Now, on the left portion of the screen, once again, you also have weekly quests, and unlike your daily quests, these quests specifically are completed over a week span. Now, you can complete 10 of these weekly quests per day, and a total of 70 per week, so 10 per day, 7 days a week, giving you a total of 70 weekly quests. Now, another great feature of these daily and weekly quests is they do scale with level. So depending on your level, they are always applicable, always of value, and are worth your overall time investment. And personally for me, they are a very refreshing feature, as when you are progressing through the main storyline quest, sometimes you want a nice change of pace, and these really do fulfill that. Also, players can choose to take advantage of the shop, which feature a really cool feature called quest scrolls. Now, like many things in the game, these quest scrolls have a grade system. And in fact, these quest scrolls are one of the greatest ways to earn bonus experience and level up quickly. And I really do think this is a revolutionary concept, as it prevents players from feeling stuck in their leveling experience and really adds infinite content. So go out there and be sure to take advantage of this feature to make sure you're ahead of your friends. Now, let's say you are doing your main story quest and you've completed all of your daily quests and you're on track to complete your weekly quest, but you still need some bonus experience. Lineage 2 Revolution has so many options and methods for leveling up. They even offer elite dungeons. So head to the top of your screen, click those 3 bars at the top. In the bottom left corner of the screen, you'll see an option for dungeon. And you'll see a ton of different dungeon options that you can choose to complete for various rewards, but one of them is titled Elite Dungeon. Now, when it comes to Elite Dungeons, there are different levels of difficulty based on your level, so you can choose one that scales with your level, and these Elite Dungeons will offer different quests that reset daily that will offer you experience and addenda. So it is important to remember to choose the Elite Dungeon set for your level to gain the correct amount of experience and earn those adequate rewards. And these Elite Dungeon quests reset daily, and they are relatively easy to complete, so you can choose to group up with your friends or enter solo. Also, when it comes to Elite Dungeons, there is an interesting feature that I picked up from Swifty a couple days ago. You can actually leave your character on using the auto battle feature inside of the Elite Dungeon, and your character will gain experience for you and acquire loot, and you can set the type of loot that you'd like to pick up using the loot feature in the options. And this is an easy way to gain bonus experience while you're AFK. So if you want to take a quick nap or you're hanging out with your friends, you can leave your character fighting these elite monsters and gain experience while you're not even there. Now, another cool dungeon is the Trial of Experience, and you can take advantage of this 2 times per day. However, like many things in Lineage 2 Revolution, you can reset these attempts using your diamonds. Now, this dungeon offers a base level of experience reward as well as a bonus experience reward depending on how well you do and how many mobs you clear out in the allowed time. Also, Lineage 2 Revolution offers ways to gain experience through your clan. Being in a clan is one of the easiest ways to earn experience. So if you're not in a clan, be sure to join one, as it does improve the overall quality of the game and offers various exciting features that every player should look to take advantage of. Now, like I discussed in my clan video, you can donate your Adena, your Proof of Blood, or your Red Star Stones to take advantage of clan coins, which can simply be used to purchase raw experience from the clan shop. You can do this 10 times per day, and again, that can be reset with your diamonds. Now, when in a clan, you can also take advantage of the fireplace, and it's another really easy way to earn bonus experience. Now, the way this works, after completing clan hall quests, you begin to earn an item called kindling for your clan. And after earning a total of 200 kindling, your clan leader can use this kindling to start a fire at the clan fireplace. Players can stand next to it to earn massive amounts of experience. The more clan members that come to the fire, the more experience everyone earns. Now, finally, Lineage 2 Revolution will also offer you experience after being away from the game for several hours. When you come back to the game, you will notice at the top of your screen under the events tab, there is a section called Recess Reward, and that is a simple way for Lineage 2 to give you free experience after being away from the game. You eventually will accumulate recess points that you can spend to earn free experience. So if you haven't logged in a few days, don't feel discouraged. Take advantage of this feature and once again, catch up to your friends. So when it comes to Lineage 2, there are so many ways that players can choose to level up. And I hope following this video that you guys have a better grasp on how to level up quickly. But that's the end of this video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give the video a thumbs up. If you have any more questions about this game or leveling up in general, you can leave them in the comment section below and I'll get back to you guys right away. Try not to miss me on my YouTube live stream or answer all of your guys' questions in depth. Do not forget to subscribe and I'll see you guys next time.